In this video, we will cover the Iraqi Shia paramilitary group Kata'ib Hezbollah, a group that sometimes also is called Hezbollah Brigades and Hezbollah in Iraq, and must not be confused with Lebanese Hezbollah. Topics covered here will be its history, its military strength, its sources of revenue, and where it have a presence. Its general secretary was Abu Mahdi al-Muhandis up until January 3, 2020. He was killed in an American drone strike together with Qasem Suleimani, leader of the Iranian Quds Force. Kata'ib Hezbollah is a part of Iraq's popular mobilization forces and is considered to be one of the three largest pro-Iranian militias there, together with Asaib al-Haq and the Badr organization. The largest, the Badr organization, is described as the heart of the popular mobilization forces, while Kata'ib Hezbollah and its leadership is described as its head. Even though Kata'ib Hezbollah is not the largest of the militias, it's reportedly the most secretive and well-trained of them. Today, Kata'ib Hezbollah is described as the main threat from Iraqi Shiite militias to the US presence in Iraq. It is viewed as part of the axis of resistance and is regarded as an important major militant force alongside the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps, Quds Force, and the Lebanese Hezbollah. There is a lot of confusion about when Kata'ib Hezbollah was founded, from statements saying it was founded in 2001 to several places in Wikipedia where it says it was founded in 2003, or more specifically in October that year, and other sources again say it was founded in 2006. But the best assumption is that the group was officially founded in April 2007 by Abu Mahdi al-Muhandis as a union of five other militant organizations, as stated by two articles in Stanford Center for International Security and Cooperation and a well-documented article from December 2019 in Voice of America, and also by the fact that no attacks were claimed by the group before 2008 makes it unlikely that it was active in Iraq since 2003. From early 2007 till the coalition withdrawal of its main combat forces in 2011, Kata'ib Hezbollah waged guerrilla war against the foreign forces. Most of Kata'ib Hezbollah's attacks was in the Shia-populated areas of Iraq, mostly being against US forces in the Baghdad area and British forces further south. The first attacks proven to be from Kata'ib Hezbollah occurred in February 2008 on a US base southeast of Baghdad, but it's assumed that attacks from Kata'ib Hezbollah already started in the first half of 2007. The first report of Kata'ib Hezbollah forces being deployed in Syria comes from Reuters in October 2012. During the first period of Iraqi Shiite deployment to Syria in that year, the Shiite groups did not send forces in their own names, but used the name of Liwa Abu Fadl al-Abbas as a front group, and Kata'ib Hezbollah and the larger Badr organization cooperated in that sense. Since early 2013, the Shiite militias began sending forces in their own name, and in March 2013, Kata'ib Hezbollah officially acknowledged it had lost fighters in Syria. It was engaged in the fighting around Aleppo, and it also helped raise local Shiite militias in that area. In 2015, Kata'ib Hezbollah claimed it had contributed 1,000 fighters in the Aleppo area, and also that year it built a martyrs section in a cemetery in Najaf devoted to fighters lost in Syria. And in 2016, the group was stated as having an office in a government-controlled part of Aleppo. Because of the battle for Mosul that began in late 2016, Kata'ib Hezbollah scaled down in Syria and transferred 2,000 of its fighters back to Iraq to participate in the battle, but at the same time they continued to secure the government-held parts of Aleppo. In December 2017, the group took part in the offensive to retake the important Syrian border city of Abu Kamal. That city had significant value for Iran as it created a land supply route from Tehran to Lebanon, facilitating the provision of ordnance to the Lebanese Hezbollah. Since that time, Kata'ib Hezbollah has had a strong presence in the Abu Kamal era of eastern Deir ez-Zor, sometimes fighting together with the Syrian Arab army against Islamic State remnants or being attacked by Israeli or US air power. Because of increasing strength of the Islamic State and worsened security situation in 2012 to 2014, Kata'ib Hezbollah began more actively in 2013 to fight against Islamic State and other Sunni militant organizations. In June 2014, with the fall of Mosul and the collapse of the Iraqi army, Kata'ib Hezbollah took a heavy part in fighting, with the establishment of the popular mobilization forces together with six other Shia paramilitary groups, and a huge increase in recruitment, with the troop numbers for Kata'ib Hezbollah stated to be as high as 30,000 by their own assessment. In late 2016 to early 2017, the group played a significant role in retaking Mosul, and in November 2017, Kata'ib Hezbollah was a participant in retaking the western parts of al-Anbar with its important city of al-Qa'im, where it still have a huge presence as of today. In May 2019, two Saudi oil facilities were attacked and damaged, probably by explosive-laden drones. Even though the Yemeni Houthis claim they did it, other sources claim the attacks came from drones originating from a Kata'ib Hezbollah-controlled area southwest of Baghdad, called Yurf as-Sakr, launched in coordination between Kata'ib Hezbollah and the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps. Assessing troop numbers for Kata'ib Hezbollah is not an easy task, because of the large fluctuations in numbers from different sources. But even if numbers fluctuate, approximate trends can be drawn. In the years from 2010 and 2011, there were several sources stating that Kata'ib Hezbollah had from 400 and up to 2,000 fighters. After most of the coalition combat troops left Iraq in 2011, and that Kata'ib Hezbollah started sending fighters to Syria in the end of 2012, a safe assumption can be drawn that the group's manpower increased significantly. In June 2014, at the founding of the Popular Mobilization Forces, Kata'ib Hezbollah was assessed to have approximately 10,000 fighters, and after the mass mobilization that occurred after that, together with the collapse of the Iraqi army, the numbers had swelled up to 30,000 in the end of that year. In December 2019, the US Military Academy's Combating Terrorism Center stated that the total force of Kata'ib Hezbollah was 10,000, and of those were 2,500 stationed in Syria and 7,500 in Iraq. When taking into account that the group controlled three of the brigades attached to the Popular Mobilization Forces, and that the situation today is different than the mass mobilization that happened in the end of 2014, the 10,000 number is not an unrealistic account, and it can be safe to assume that in case of mobilization, Kata'ib Hezbollah could probably again in a short time swell its numbers up to 2014 levels, which had around 30,000 fighters. From early 2007 till 2008, Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps and Lebanese Hezbollah had helped Kata'ib Hezbollah establish and run clandestine training camps in southern Iraq, until they were during 2008 forced to relocate to bases in Iran and areas in Lebanon where the Lebanese Hezbollah had control. The training camps in Iran were controlled by the Quds Force and were near Tehran, Qom, Ahvaz and Mashhad. In those areas, Kata'ib Hezbollah were trained in building and planting IEDs and were also provided in relatively advanced explosively formed penetrators, which they used with high effect against coalition vehicles. They were trained in guerrilla hit and run tactics, adopting the methods of Lebanese Hezbollah, and they also earned a reputation for using improvised rocket-assisted mortars against coalition bases. They got also training in coordinating and carrying out mortar, sniper, indirect rocket and rocket-propelled grenade attacks. Suicide attacks were also sometimes used against foreign forces, even though that was more common amongst Salafist Sunni insurgents. In December 2009, Kata'ib Hezbollah conducted a sophisticated cyber attack, hacking into US Predator drone feeds in Iraq in order to monitor and evade US military operations. This has led many to believe that the organization has a relatively sophisticated cyber unit or specialist working under its command. When Kata'ib Hezbollah started to deploy in Syria in late 2012, that resulted in the injection of new, intense battlefield experience, quite different from when they fought a guerrilla war against the coalition forces. Before being deployed in Syria, troops were sent to Iran and Lebanon, where they learned to adapt the insurgent tactics commonly used in Iraq to the urban street fighting more common in Syria. By 2014, when the Iraqi civil war began and the collapse of the Iraqi army after the fall of Mosul, the group received increased supplies from Iran, and that, among other, included new supplies of Ashtar and Karar improvised rocket-assisted mortars. That is heavy rockets with short range and much more explosive power than typical Katyusha rockets that are more usable for longer ranges. Firing ramps for those improvised rocket-assisted mortars were often mounted on vehicles, and the more typical multiple rocket launchers also were, to give the group a mobile artillery function. By 2015, a base near Samarra in north-central Iraq was being used to train Kata'ib Hezbollah fighters. In the summer of that same year, there were claims that Kata'ib Hezbollah helped train Bahraini Shia militants from the Al-Ashtar Brigades group, a group that had been waging a low-level insurgency in that Shia-majority country that is ruled by Sunni minority. In March 2016, amounts of used equipment was identified as being used by Kata'ib Hezbollah, including an Abrams tank, several armored personnel carriers, Humvees and howitzers. Some of these weapons were delivered by the US-supplied Iraqi army without US consent, while some of it was also equipment recaptured from the Islamic State during the fighting. In August 2018, an article in Reuters claimed that Iran had begun transferring small numbers of short-range ballistic missiles to Shiite militia-controlled areas in Iraq, and that they were also preparing for production of those missiles in two facilities at Al-Safarinya, east of Baghdad, and in Yurf as-Sakr, southwest of the same city. It is known that Kata'ib Hezbollah receives funding from Iran, as stated by reports by the US Treasury Department in both 2008 and 2010, and it is claimed by a report by Stanford Center for International Security and Cooperation that Kata'ib Hezbollah receives an estimated $50 million from Iran each year. Among the domestic sources of revenue are cross-border smuggling and commerce, especially between the Syrian-Iraqi border area of western Al-Anbar and eastern Deir ez-Zor, because of its group's control of the Qaim Abu Kamal border crossing, and also maintaining checkpoints along Highway 20 that goes southward and coordinated via a Kata'ib Hezbollah base near the western city of Rutba. And also, most units of the popular mobilization forces, like Kata'ib Hezbollah, maintain offices in numerous parts of Iraq for fundraising and recruitment. As of 2020, Kata'ib Hezbollah have a military presence in both Syria and Iraq. In Iraq, it have a strong presence in three of the brigades of the popular mobilization forces, that is, Brigades 45, 56 and 57. As mentioned, it has a strong presence in western Anbar, especially from Qaim and westward, and going south along the Syrian border till Rutba, where the group have a base near a large former airbase called H3. In Nuqaib, in the south, not too far from Saudi Arabia, Kata'ib Hezbollah has six locations. It is also present in Shiite areas of Baghdad and especially in Palestine Street. Camp Spicer, a large military base northwest of Tikrit, is also dominated by this group. And further 40 kilometers southwest of the city, in Yurf as-Sakr, their presence is probably the strongest, where they have total control with its own prisons and where bases are outside of state control. It is from this area that the US alleged that drones came from that attacked the northeastern Saudi oil facilities in September 2019. And it's also in Yurf as-Sakr that there are suspected missile production facilities. In Syria, Kata'ib Hezbollah is still believed to have a military presence in Aleppo, and also its presence is strong in southeastern Deir ez-Zor in conjunction with the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps. In the later years, there have been established several new Shiite militias that is part of the popular mobilization forces, and that is also loyal to both Kata'ib Hezbollah's former General Secretary Abi Mahdi al-Muhandis and the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps Quds Force. There are at least 10 different Shiite militias that fall under this category. They're not as large as Kata'ib Hezbollah, but according to a report by Combating Terrorism Center in August 2019, in total they constitute around 22,500 personnel, and are parts of 10 of the Popular Mobilization Forces brigades, and therefore must be regarded as an important part in conjunction with Kata'ib Hezbollah. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed.